So guys, in today's video, I'm going to share one app with you guys. So you may be familiar with the Always On Display, which was announced with the Galaxy S7 and the Note 7 now, and also the G5. Now the G5 has kind of like a LCD display, whereas the Galaxy S7 has an AMOLED display where the black pixels have been totally turned off and the only portion which is like informative is only lit up. But as you know, LG G5 is a like LCD display and it has two displays inside it, which like only displays when the information is to be displayed, which is also called like always on display or AOD service. So many of the apps may like give you an example how these things work, but they drain a battery a lot. And now I have found this app through a forum. I don't know whether it's been like available on the Play Store. If it is available, I will leave a link in the description for that and also for this app. So let's just move on. So as you can see, the clock is fully working and this is an LCD display. This is a U-Euphoria and it's quite dark. And double tap to wake also works, which is cool. Many of like Xiaomi guys would want it, because no Samsung has it unless you have like a Galaxy J Max, which has it. Okay, that would be good. So here is the app. So if you want your text messages to be displayed on your always on display, just go to settings, go to the apps, let them load. Here is the first one, always on display, just a simple clean name, permissions, phones and contacts. So if you have like call logs or contacts, it would be like displayed on the always on display. I wouldn't recommend like putting a much crap on your device, so it would like wouldn't drain a battery. And I have been checked it a lot since it was 1 hour and only it like drained only around 2%, which is very good for LCD display. I don't know how it would be on a AMOLED display, which would be like have it on some like OnePlus 3, which also has a AMOLED display, so it would be much greater or no battery drain at all. So it's highly customizable, not like a Galaxy S7. Here we have the general settings, show battery, and you also get a nice preview. So here is the battery. I would not recommend, cause it just takes another part of the screen. It won't like drain the battery same, but I don't like it. I just like a plain one. Here also the brightness is available. It wouldn't like recommend you to save your battery. In pocket mode is also, and it works pretty fine. It just turns off if you like holding the device upright and something is like over the proximity sensor. In constant position. So if you have an AMOLED device or a LED display AMOLED, if you don't know, please turn on this in constant position like option, because if you turn on this AOD service and it just stays over there, you will have a screen burning. For example, if you turn on the device, it would be stayed like here and it would like damage your device. So please turn on this option. As you can see, it tells for a LED display, so the position will bounce every minute so it wouldn't have a burning. It's also very neat feature. Wake up on charge plug, that's not recommended things. Height and width, this would be perfect, not like huge or not like very small. 24 hour format, no. Show seconds, not recommended. Preview, that's quite good, and it's exactly like my Galaxy S7, no doubt. Only this looks blue on my S7, which is green over here. Date settings, I wouldn't recommend it, but it's available though. As you can see at the top, it's quite ugly, so I just disabled that. Notification settings, you do get notifications of messages and contacts. Hidden notification from apps. Okay, so it can utilize your WhatsApp and Messenger messages too, I guess. Yep. And this is not available on the Galaxy S7 or not the G5. I didn't know about the G5 if it has an upgrade, but as I own a Galaxy S7, it doesn't have this feature. notifications I would turn off. I don't like a crap on my like black screen, and it's very beautiful to look at. I have a Galaxy 7 and it's always on display. It's very beautiful to look at because it is very informative. So let's just take a quick look, and there we have it, our always on display on our LCD device. So in my 2 to 3 hours of testing it on this Euphoria, which is a 5 inch screen, it would drain about something of 3 to 2%, which is not a huge battery drain. And almost if this device can get with the Snapdragon 14 processor, it's a very popular chipset actually, so it would be good in terms of optimization. It would be very much help if you dropped a like, and thanks for watching. Peace.